As Canada's National Museum of Sport, we have a platform and an obligation to amplify marginalized voices and share the lived experiences of marginalized Hall of Famers. Today, we bring you the story of CFL legend, Norm "Normie" Quong. In his sporting career, the late Norm Quong was known as the first Chinese-Canadian to compete in the Canadian Football League. In addition to being a part of four Grey Cup winning teams, Quong garnered many incredible statistics, including scoring over 70 touchdowns and running almost 10,000 yards. However, the journey to the top of his game was not an easy one. Growing up in Calgary with his family, Quong was forced to deal with racism from a young age. Quong's son Marty describes what it was like for his father.
He grew up where there was, verbal taunts. There were oftentimes fights that he would get into simply because of someone calling him a name.
Quong lived in Calgary during the Chinese Immigration Act, also referred to as the Chinese Exclusion Act, which included policies that impacted his childhood. One policy of this act meant that Quong was not permitted to swim in a public pool. His son Marty shares the impact this had on his father.
He always talked about that sign, no dogs or Chinese allowed. He talked about not getting the opportunity to swim. I think it did burn within him. But again, I think overall he just said, if that's the way it is, that's the way life is, this is my opportunity, I will pursue something else.
During this time, he not only fought for himself, but for others, as recalled by his son, Brad.
He not only faced racial discrimination as a Chinese in his neighborhood, but he had to fight the fights of other kids who were mixed race. He told me that many of the fights he had were protecting the kid who was half Chinese and half German, or half Japanese and half French, or whatever, so of mixed race.
Despite what Quong faced, it was important for him to teach his children that the best way to combat racism was to prove anyone who called them racial slurs wrong. His son, Randy, was driven by his father's advice.
And they would call you every single racial slur in the book, up and down. And I didn't know what my dad would say, because I knew that he had faced everything. He would just kind of insinuate that, yeah, I've been through this. And he would say, like, Randy, just beat them on the ice. Beat them. Like, check them. Score a goal, try and get past them. So I think he was trying to push us, I think for me, push me in a direction of like, don't be a victim. People are going to try and, tear you down. If they think you're better than you, then they're going to try and tear you down.
Despite the prejudice he endured growing up in Alberta, Norm Quong went on to become the first Chinese Canadian Lieutenant Governor of Alberta. His son, Greg, discusses the impact of this on his father.
During his 5 years as lieutenant governor, I saw him break down a number of times, usually giving a public speech about the barrier of being the first Chinese person to become lieutenant governor and the issues he faced. And especially when he was talking to children, I know he became more emotional.
Speaking about his role as lieutenant governor, Quong stated,
"My role, I feel, is to encourage people of Alberta to be proud Albertans, to be proud Canadians, to encourage them to seek a more active lifestyle, to encourage seniors to be more active, to encourage youth to be more active, and to be good citizens of the country."
Quong was an excellent representation of what he wanted other Canadians to emulate, and he received many accolades for living a life of service to his sport and his community. Some of the most notable include the dedication of the gymnasium in the Canadian Embassy in Beijing in his name, the creation of the Normie Quong Bursary by donor endowment in the Faculty of Medicine at the University of Calgary in his honor, and his appointment as Knight of the Order of St. John of Jerusalem by Queen Elizabeth II. Norm Quong made tremendous contributions to sport and to our country. We can do better. We will do better.